Assalamualaikum. My name is Widi Mutakin from Expose Academy. I am an entrepreneur and also an academic lecturer in computer graphic disciplines. In this course, we're going to cover the basic concept and techniques on how to use material, color, and texture inside Blender. I must warn you though that this course is not designed for complete beginners. If you have basic working skill and already understand how to model simple 3D objects in Blender, feel free to jump in and join this class. But if you're really new to Blender, I suggest that you take the essential course first and/or the 3D modeling fundamentals first before taking this one. In this course, we will start discussing about rendering engines exist in Blender and how they will affect materials. And then we'll move on to how we can create and assign materials to 3D objects. We will cover how to assign materials to multiple objects and vice versa, assign multiple materials to a single object. We will also cover the essential theories about color models, and also how bit per channel data affect color depth, and the underlying theory behind hexadecimal color codes. After that, we move on to textures. We're going to discuss different types of texture. Then we focus on how we can create procedural texture in Blender. Next, we learn how to import and create image-based textures. In Blender, we can have multiple layered textures, each with its own blending modes. By combining all of these features, we can create a wide variety of texture effects that you can imagine. Next, we will get to know more in depth about UV image editor, and then the basic introduction about PBR or physically based rendering workflow, which is the trend in texturing workflow in the computer graphic world. After all of these lessons, at the end, we will have a hands-on project on creating lotus leaf object from a single face with the help of textures. We will add color texture and alpha texture. Also an alternative method using RGBA images. Then we'll discuss about different types of bump texturing, such as using normal map, and then height map, or also known as displacement map. Then finally, we will continue our hands-on project by adding height map to it, and then specular map. After finishing this course, you will have strong foundations on how material, color, and textures work in general, applicable to any 3D software. Also, you will have basic practical skills on how to work with material, color, and texture inside Blender. So, join now and take your 3D skill to the next level.